Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Chapter 11, Database Concepts. Here, database means is a collection of data that stored together to serve multiple applications as possible. Let us see some real-time example. Databases are used anywhere that data needs to be stored and easily retrieved. You might not realize it, but databases are everywhere. Whether you know very much about them, their effect on our daily lives is extensive. From weather applications to the movies you watch online, databases are responsible for many of the services which utilize daily. Any online streaming service such as Netflix, it uses database to generate a list of TV shows and movies to watch. The database tracks in an individual show's preferences and provide a list of recommended viewing. This power required to analyze such an enormous amount of data is done through highly specialized database management technology. And another one example is gaming field. So in the gaming field, gaming done across social networks is extremely data intensive. So here, gathering individual player information from around the globe and serving it to the player and on demand requires a high availability database software. Let us see some real-time simple examples like bank. So in bank uses databases to keep tracks of customer accounts, balance and deposits, etc. Here, this type of database just maintain the customer accounts and availability of balance and deposits. Suppose in a retail store means, it can use database to store price, what are the cost of the particular item, customer information, sales information, how much sales today, and quantity of hand. So here, the learning objectives are, after completion of this chapter, you will be able to know concepts of a database and relational database, and also know different components of the database, and will know the types of database models and types of relationship and the concepts of relational algebra. Let us see the introduction. Here, database is an organized collection of data. Organized collection of data is nothing but simply collected data. It generally stored and accessed electronically from a computer system. So it means, let us see the real-time example, like your class attendance. So your class attendance is a simple database. Here your names are data. Your names are stored in a particular database. So here whether marking if you are present or absent is the accessing of the database. Here databases have been around since people started recording things. It must focus on electronic ones. Here database is often usually to refer both the database and the DBMS used to manipulate it. Let us see what is mean by data. Here, data means it's a characteristic information that are collected through observation. It's a characteristic information that are collected through observation. It means simply raw fact. It's stored in a computer. It may contain a character or a text or a word, whatever may be. Let us see the example. Example 600006. So it's a number. So some pin code. Next one is DPA campus, SCRT, Chennai College Road. So it's all the string, it's a number. So here information means it's a formatted data. That means facts provide or learnt about something. It's a collection of data to provide a meaningful information. That means collect panna data ellathayum or meaningful information adhaadu or meaningful la maathradhu dhaan enna information oda vera data na anganga potupanga information, the data is all that collect pani or meaningful information. Let us see this example. ACRT. So it's a college name, College Road, DP Campus, Chennai 6006. So here this example appears as a set of words and numbers, but when the data is processed, organized and formalized, it gives a meaningful information about the particular institution contact address. So data means raw facts, collection of data into a meaningful information. So collection of data into a meaningful order means information. Next one is database. What is mean by database? Is a collection of information that is organized so that it can be easily accessed or managed and updated the data. So here database is a repository collection of related data organized in a search way that can be easily accessed, managed and updated. Here this is a software or hardware, it based on our purpose. So here database management system. Database management system is a software that allows it is used to manage the database. Whether it can be create a database or define the database and access in the data in the database, allowing users to store, process and analyze data easily. Whether database management system provides as an interface or tool to perform the various operations. So here database management provides protection and security to the databases. So example of DBMS software are Foxflow, DBase, etc. Here in our practical session we are using the MySQL database system. So next one is characteristic of database management system. Here some characteristics. First one is data stored into tables. Here data is never directly stored into the database. It's stored in the table format. Here table means it's a row and column method. Next one is reduced redundancy. Here what does mean by redundancy? Redundancy, reduced redundancy means is a system design in which a component is duplicated. Suppose if it is files, there will be a backup. So in the modern world, hard drives are very cheap. But earlier when hard drives are too expensive. So because of this problem in the database, we are follow the DBMS using normalization, which divides the data in such a way that repetition is minimum. Repetition is kami pandradhukaga namba idu use pannom. Next one is data consistency. Data consistency is nothing but usability of data. Data consistency means usability of data. Next one is on live data, it is being continuously updated and added. Maintaining the consistency of data can become a challenge. It's nothing but இப்போ உன்னோட மொபைல்ல காண்டாக்ட் புக் இருக்கு, சடனா ஒரு காண்டாக்டை ஆட் பண்ற, ஆட் பண்ணி போன் புக்ல அதை ஆட் ஆகிடும். தட் மீன்ஸ் உன்னோட காண்டாக்ட்ல ஆட் ஆகிடும். ஸோ லைவா நீ பண்ண பண்ண ஒவ்வொரு அப்டேஷனும் சேஞ்ச் ஆகுறது டேட்டாபேஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் சிஸ்டத்துல பாசிபிள். ஸோ ஹியர் திஸ் யூசபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் டேட்டா வந்து ரொம்ப சேலஞ்சா இருந்துச்சு, ஆனா இது டிபிஎம்எஸ்ல பாசிபிளா இருந்துச்சு. ஸோ ஹியர் இட்ஸ் மீன் இட் கேன் ஹேண்டில் பை த டேட்டா whenever the user is friendly. Next one is support multiple user and concurrent access. So DBMS allows multiple users to work on it, whether you update, insert or delete the data at the same time and also still manage to maintain the data consistency. Here this type of, so multiple users can perform the multiple operations. Next one is query language. So query language means a language for the specification of procedure for the retrieval of information from the database. So here language for the specification. Here this language specification for the retrieval of data, that is access of the data. Here DBMS provides user with a simple query language, using which data can be easily fetched, inserted, deleted and updated in a database. Like C, Python is a programming language. C, Python, C++ is a programming language. Query language is used to access in the database management system. Next one is security. So here it is, the security means is the state of being free from danger of threat. So in this database management system, it takes care of the security of data. It protecting the data from the unauthorized accessor. So it means it protect from the hackers. So in a typical DBMS, we can create user accounts with different access permissions using when which we can easily secure our data by restricting user access. Next one is DBMS support transactions. It allows us to better handle and manage data integrity in real world applications where multithreading is extensively used. It's nothing but here support transaction. It's a multi-level transaction means it manages data integrity in a different fields. Next one is advantages of TPMS. First point is segregation of application program. Here segregation is nothing but separation. So here the action of state or setting something apart from others. So segregation means separation of application program. Next one is minimal data duplications or data redundancy. And third one is easy retrieval of data using the query language. Fourth one is reduced development time and maintenance. So first one is separation. Second one is minimal data duplications or data redundancy. That means data duplication, number of duplicate copies will be the minimum range. Easy retrieval of data using the query language. And also reduced development time and maintenance. And next one is component of DPMS. So what are the components of DPMS? Here DPMS has 5 major components. First one is hardware. So already we know what is meant by hardware. It is the physical component of a computer or an electronic system. Next one is software. So software means here the programs and other operating information used by a computer. So here software means is an instructions which are given by the computer. It's a set of programs. Third one is data. Data means a raw fact. And fourth one is procedures or methods. So here procedures or method is nothing but set of functions. Fifth one is database access language. So here database access language means query languages. See here, first one is hardware and software. Hardware is the physical component, software is the program. Here this both hardware or software which are used by the user through via the database languages. It has follows a set of procedures and methods. And next one is hardware. Here hardware means computer, hard disk or input output channels for data and any other physical component which is involved in the storage of a data. So what are the physical components which is used to storage the data in the database which are going to consider under the hardware part. So here the software means is a set of instructions or a set of programs. So it controls everything. So through via the program, it controls everything. So DBMS software is capable of understanding the database access languages and also interprets into database commands for execution. And next one is data. So here data is nothing but which is the resource, that is the raw fact for which DBMS designed. Whether it is used to create, to store and utilize the data. Fourth one is procedures or methods. Here procedures or methods is nothing but set of functions to access the particular DBMS. So there have a set of procedures for installation of DBMS and also how to manage DBMS. So to take backups, reports, generation, etc. So eppadi vandu install pandradhu abingiradhu dhaan set of procedures or methods. We are going to access the performing the particular database have a set of operations. So here this operation which you are going to consider under the part of procedures or methods. Fifth one is database access languages. Here this is nothing but query language which is used to write commands to access, insert, update and delete data stored in any databases. Examples of some popular database DBase and FoxPro. So Here is the example for the DBase and the FoxWorm. Did you know Facebook use which type of database? Here Facebook uses database like Facebook, which you are having a username ID and password. Here these types of databases or this type of data are stored in a particular database. So which means Facebook la ID create pannuva, password create pannuva, unoda ID um password um match aanadha unoda account ku pogum. So inda ID password indradhu or kind of data, inda data store aagradhu or particular place la store aagum. So adhu poi check pannunadhana unoda username potu password potu unoda ID ah poi check pannu. So idha or database oda access. So here this type of data, in this type we are using the databases in the real world. For Facebook uses MySQL database, Instagram uses PostgreSQL and Cassandra. Like you are going to search YouTube uses what kind of database, and WhatsApp uses what kind of database. And also it is the best career to choose whether some techniques to using the database management system. Next one is database structure. So here, what is in the database structure? So here already we learned database is not directly stored in the file. It is stored in the form of a table. Here table is the entire collection of related data in one table. Here each row in the table represent as a record, which is a set of data for each database entry. And also column is represent as a field which groups each piece or item of data among records into the specific categories or types of data. Example, student numbers, student name, student age. So we are going to make a table: student numbers, student name, student age, student class, student section. So among this, we are going to fill the particular row as first one is name. Name is Raj. Here the student number is 1. Student name is Raj. Student age is 16. Class is 12th C1. Student class is 12th. Student section is C1. So in this particular row is represented as a record, which is a set of data for a particular person's information. So here a table is known as a relation. So just marked, it's an important one word question. A table is known as a relation, a row is known as a tuple, a column is known as a attribute. Let us see the example. Here student number, student name, student age, student class, student section. So here this column, student name is student age, student class, student section, it represent the attributes. But 1101 Kannan, so it represent the row. So here in this table relation, which we are going to access the unique ID, that is a particular user information, just have to enter the student number. Suppose I enter the student number 1101, it relate the display the information, whatever relate the 1101, display the student name, student age, student class, student section, etc. And next one is data model. Here data model means it describes the data, how the data can be represented and accessed from a software after complete implementation. It is a simple abstraction of the complex real world data gathering environment. Data model na or software na complete mudichitta senju mudichadukapramaati just na demo paakuren indha model ipdi na varum indha software ipdi dhaan function aagum na demo paakuren adha maadhiri dhaan here the data can be represented and accessed ellame na mudichitom final complete implementation ku or demo paakuren adha enadhu data model, how the data are stored in this database. Here this main purpose is to give an idea as how the final system or software will look like after development is completed. Let us see some types of the data model: hierarchical model, relational model, network database model, entity relationship model, object model. Here hierarchical model, it represents tree-like data form. So here the data is going to store is in the tree-like data structure. And next one is relational model. Relational model already we will discuss. It is a table-like structure. And third one is network database model. It is the extent of hierarchical model. Fourth one is entity relationship model. It is based on objects and characteristics. Here objects means it went to the entities and characteristics means attributes. And for final one is object model. Here this type of object model is used in more complicated applications which you are going to apply some OOPs concept. First one is hierarchical model. This is the one of the important 5-mark question and also it is the book bag question. First one is hierarchical model. Hierarchical model was developed by IBM as information management system. So in the IBM, so information management system which is developed by the hierarchical model. So here this model, a data is represented as a simple tree-like structure form. So and also it represents the one-to-many relationship. Here one-to-many relationship means parent to child relationship. So what is mean by parent to child relationship? So here one child has only one parent, but a parent have many child. So here one parent has many children. Here this model is mainly used in IBM mainframe computers. Let us see the another one. See the example. School. So in the school has a parent mode. So here courses and the resources are the children mode. So after courses it act as a parent mode. Here theory or lab is the child mode. So here one parent has many children, but one parent have many children. Next one is relational model. Here relational model, it was proposed by E.F. Cordon 1970. Here this basic structure of data in relational model, that is tables. Here it will be stored in a rows and columns. Here a relation key is an attribute which uniquely identify a particular tuple information like student ID, name, age, subject ID, name, teacher. So here I want this table from student ID and subject ID and marks. So now I insert an student ID, subject ID, marks column. So if our student patrin information meno pona na student ID e port odiye avana patna ella information um view aago. So adukaga nam adhaadu or student ID ingradhu particular tuples la irukku, adhaadu particular row la irukku. So which is used to uniquely identify a particular user information. Just I am entering your registration number, whatever your details, after I entering this number it displays the details in my screen. Third one is network model. Here network database model is an extended form of hierarchical data model. Here the difference between the hierarchical model and network model is hierarchical model has one child has only one parent node, but in a network model it has one children have many parent nodes. It represents the data in many to many relationship and also it is used to easier and faster to access the data. First one is school. Here school is the parent node. So next one is library, office, staff room. Here this library, office, staff room are the child node. Here this child has some parent node as student. So here this all the accessibilities which are accessed by the student node. So here student is the parent node. Let us see this example. The library is the child node, office is the child node, staff is the child node under the parent node of school. So after it performs the each parent node like library, office and staff room. Here this each parent node has the child node of student. So here school represents the parents node, library, office and staff room, it is a child to school. So it is a parent node. Next one is student is a child to library, office and staff room. So here it follows the one to many relationship. Fourth one is entity relationship model. Here entity relationship model, it is created by dividing the object into entity and its characteristics into attributes. This model was developed by Chen in 1976. Here this model is useful in developing a conceptual design for the database. Here it represents, if it is entities means it represent rectangle, attributes means it represent the ellipse, and diamond means it represent the relationship in the diagram. Example, doctor diagnoses the patient. So here doctor, what are the entities of the doctor? So here the entities, two entities, doctor, patient. Okay, so it represent the rectangle shape. And next one is ellipse, it represent the attributes. So what are the attributes for the doctor? Is doctor ID, doctor name. Patient means patient ID, patient name. So what is the relationship between the doctor and patient? Just diagnosis of disease. So here this relationship, it represent the relationship it represent the diamond shape. Next one is, so here doctor diagnoses the patient. Doctor has the certain attributes of doctor ID, doctor name, and also patient has the certain attributes of patient ID and patient name. Now next one is object model. Here object model stores the data in the form of objects, attributes and methods, classes and inheritance, such as OOPS concept. So in this model has more complex applications such as GIS, that is geographic information system, scientific experiments, engineering design and manufacturing. Here it is using file management system. It represents some real world objects, attributes and behavior. Let us see the example. Here is the example of object model. First one is shape, get area, get perimeter. Here shape, circle, rectangle and triangle are the objects. So here shape is the object model, circle, rectangle, triangle are the objects. So here rectangle has the circle has the attribute radius. So circle has the attribute radius. If you are going to calculate the circle, then only you are going to calculate the area and perimeter. So now we are going to perform the function as area and perimeter. So rectangle has the attribute length and breadth, triangle has the attribute base and height. So in this objects or inherit from the object shape, which are going to perform a function. So circle means what is the radius of the, so what are the, what is the area of the circle formula? A is equal to pi r square. So in this formula we are going to calculate the radius. So if it is not known the radius, we didn't calculate the area. So here area is important. And next one is types of DPMS uses. So what is mean by, what are the types of DPMS uses? First one is database administrator. Here database administrator is the one who manages the complete database management. Here they're managing the software or software installation, maintenance of the data, extraction, transformation and loading the data, and also managing the license keys. Here license keys means here it's a software product, it access authorized from the authorized users, and also it managing user accounts and access data. Next one is database recovery specialized data handling and security. So here database administrator is the man who performs complete database management processor. So here many complete data management processor. And next one is application programmers or software developers. So application programmers or software developer means here it is the user group. It is involved in developing and designing the part of DPMS. And third one is end user. Here the end user means here the applications are programmed in such a way that collected user data and store the data on DPMS systems running on the server. End user means when we who access the data to store or insert or update the data. Next one is database designers. So here database designer means or responsible for identifying the data to be stored in the database, to choose appropriate structures to represent to store the data, whether it is stored in the table or a file. Next one is difference between DPMS and ODPMS. So here DPMS means database management system. ODBMS means relational database management system. Here database management system, here data are stored in the navigational model. Navigational model means it is the data stored in the form of records. Relational model, here it's the data in tables as row and column. Here data are stored in rows and columns. And third one is data redundancy. Here data redundancy is except in DPMS. Except means present. But ODBMS it's not present. Because of this we are going to use the normalization. So here for the data redundancy purpose in ODBMS we are going to use the normalization purpose. So normalization in DBMS is not performed. But ODBMS uses normalization to reduce redundancy. Fourth one is data access. Here data access means in DBMS it consumes more time, but compared to DBMS it faster in ODBMS. Keys and indexes. So key values and index values not used in DBMS, but keys are used in ODBMS, which is used to establish the relationship. And next one is transaction management. So here the transaction management is inefficient, error prone and also insecure. So compared to DBMS, it is secure for ODBMS. Distributed databases, so it's not supported in DBMS, but it's supported by ODBMS. So here there is some example for the DBMS is DBase, FoxPro. ODBMS example is SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, MariaDB, SQLite. So now we are going to use in this in our practical session is MySQL, MariaDB server. Next one is database normalization was first proposed by Dr. Edgar F. Coe. Here ODBMS to in order to reduce some data redundancy and also improve some data integrity. This is the important rules for the EF code rules. Next one is types of relationship. So here this the data are going to be types of relationship based on in the database models, which are is going to the match from one data to the another data. First one is one-to-one relationship. Second one is one-to-many relationship. And third one is many-to-one. Fourth one is many-to-many. First one is one-to-one. So in one-to-one relationship, it means one entity is related with only one other entity. One row is linked with other row. One row in a table is linked with only one row in another table. Let us see the example. A student can have only one exam number. So here Kamal Shelby is the student which is going to the so the student exam number is 1001, like Jay Pandian 1002, Sarojini 1003. And next one is one to many relationship. Here one to many relationship means one entity is related to many other entities. That means one row in a table one is linked to the other row, but one row in a table B is linked to only one row in a table. Example, one department has many staff. Like here department, Here the staff members are computer, Tamil, maths. So here consider as a one table. Staff members are Kajalakshmi, Bindu, Radha, Rami, Radha, Ramesh, Malayaras. It's a another table. Here computer is the one role is matched with the staff in the another role. So here one data can be matched with two types of row. One data can be matched with it. So one row in a table A is linked to many rows in a table 2. But here in this table B is linked to only one row in a table 1. So in the table A is linked to many rows in table B, but table B is linked to only one row in table A. And next one is many to one relationship. Here many to one relationship means many entities can be related with only one in the other entity. Example, a number of staff members working in the one department. So here in this table, multiple rows in the staff members table is related with only one row in the department table. And next one is many to many relationship. So here many to many relationship means multiple records in a table or associated with multiple records in another table. Example, customers and product. So customers can purchase various products and products are purchased by many customers. Students and courses. Student can register many courses or course may include many students. And next one is books and students. Many books in a library are issued to many students. First one is book, second one is student. Here C++ is taken in the library by Kalivani and Manjula as well as many books are issued by the many students. And next one is relational algebra. Here what is meant by relational algebra? Relational algebra is nothing but just a procedural query language which is used to query the database tables using SQL. Here this relational algebra was first created by Edgar F. Code at IBM. So here it is used for modeling the data stored in relational databases and defining queries in it. So here it performs some operations to yield the output. And also here this output of these operations in a new relation which might be formed by one or more input relation. Let us ask, relational algebra is divided into various groups. First one is unary relational operations and next one is set theory. In the unary relational operation, first one is select. So here the symbol is sigma, next one is project, here the symbol is phi. Relational algebra operations from the set theory is union, intersection, difference, Cartesian product, which are already seen in the last chapter, set operations. So here select simple, that is sigma, which is used to select a subset of the tuples according to the given condition. Row mattu select pandradhukaga use pandrenga in the select function. So which are going to select a particular row in a particular database. Let us see the example, student number, name, course, year. So here they has a many rows, CS1, Kannan, CS2, Gauri Shankar, CS3, Lenin, CS4, Badmaja. So here the syntax is sigma course. Now I want the course. So compare in the course of big data of student. So what are the students taken by the course big data? Information about that particular student in the form of a tuple, that is role record we know. So CS1 is Kannan big data, second CSA. So here the two rows are in the big data row. First one is Kannan, second one is Lenin. So here this full row will be displayed. And next one is project. Here this projection eliminates all the attributes of the input relation but those mentioned in the projection list. It's nothing but it's going to calculate the vertical subset of the relation. So vertical subset means it's going to consider the column only, so attributes. So in the selection list we are going to take on the tuple, that is the records of a row. So in the project we are going to calculate the records of a particular column. So here the example is here pi course of student. So So what are the courses occurring in the student? There are the three courses in the above table. So what are the three courses? Big Data, Or Language, Python Programming. So what are the courses provided by the student just displayed after applying this projection statement? Next one is, see the next example is student number and course. So just explain in the basis of column. So here is the union. Already we know union means just include all the data in both table A and table B. Simple add, and also it eliminates the duplicates. So here in this set A, table A contains set of information, table B contains set of information. Student number, student name, student number, student name. So just we are going to add the both table. First one is student number is CS1 Kannan, SCS2 is Gauri Shankar, and CS2 is, see here, Gauri Shankar. Just strike out the year. CS3 is Lenin, CS4 is Badmacha. So here Lenin is occurred the two times. So here duplication is not allowed. And next one is set difference. Here the symbol is minus. So it includes all the tuples but that are in A. So it includes all the tables that are in A but not in B. So here this attribute of A has to match with the attributes of B. So remaining attributes we are going to take the A part only. We didn't take the B part. Let us see table A minus B. So here table A minus means A minus B means, see, Kannan. So Kannan is strike out. Lenin means strike out. So remaining and first one is CS4 is Badmaja. So in this set difference output is CS4 Badmaja. And for next one is intersection. Intersection it represents the common part. So common part means I define a relation consisting of a set of all tuples that are in both A and B. So here the common one is CS1 Kannan, CS3 is Lenin. And final one is product or Cartesian product. Here it is simple is X, that is the cross simple. Cross product is combining of two relations. Here this resulting relation contains both relations are combined. A cross B means A times B. So here multiplication. Okay. Let us see the simple example is table 1, 2, 3. Yes sir. So it going to, here this table A is equal to 3. Table B is equal to 2 columns. And table A cross B is 6 columns. Let us see. First one is 1, just we are going to multiple 1 years 1 hour. Next one is 2 years 2 hour. 3 years 3 hour. So here this operation it performs just merge columns from two relations. And next one is table A, table B. So here first one is CS1 Kannan and next one is CS28 Big Data. So here which type is merged? CS1 Kannan, CS28 is Big Data. So CS1 Kannan is the first table. So Kannan it takes the three courses. So first CS1 is Kannan, CS28 is Big Data. Next CS1 is Kannan, CS62 is Or Language. CS1 is Kannan, CS25 Python Programming Language. So Kannan takes this type of courses. So Big Data, Or Language, Python Programming. So here is the Python Programming is mistake, just correct it. And next one is Gauri Shankar also take this three type of courses. Big Data, Or Language, Python Programming. And third one is CS4 Badmaja, CS28 Big Data, Or Language and Python Programming. Here all kind of data A is multiple times with all kind of data with B. Let us see the points to remember. Here the database management system is a computer based record keeping system. So it can be the processed data which contains any character, text, word or number, etc. Here information is a processed data. Example of some ODBMS or MySQL, Oracle, etc. Redundancy means duplication of a data. Here data consistency means here the data values are same at all the instances of a database. Data is integrity is a security from unauthorized user. So already we know table is a relation, row means is a tuple, and columns means attribute. Here the types of data models are hierarchical, relational, network, ER and object model. Here hierarchical means simple tree-like structure, and also it represents parent to child relationship. Relational model means here data are stored in the form of relations or table. Network model is similar to hierarchical model. Here it allows the record to have more than one parent. ER model, it represents the entity